you will see the desire as beneficial, beneficial to yourself and to all of mankind, but you will have no attachment to whether this outcome comes to pass or not. For you will realize, deep inside your very being, that any appearances on the periphery of your beingness, of your consciousness, are only just that, experiences. They are not who you are, so you do not seek identification with them. You do not seek identification by suffering if they do not come to pass, and by enjoyment if they do come to pass. For your experience of satisfaction, your experience of wholeness and fullness will be untouched by the desires of your mind and whether they choose to manifest themselves here in your reality. Now, we use the mind loosely in some ways. When we talk about the mind, we talk about your consciousness as a conscious thinking entity here and now, the field of your mind stuff, the mental plane of your reality body, of your energy body here and now. For this mind itself is made of God. It is one and the same as God itself. Yet the mind can operate on different levels of experience. A purified mind will still exist as a receptor of divine intelligence of higher mind energies here and now. For a lower mind, a mind shielded off, a mind protected and separated from the greater source of itself, from all of life everywhere, will continue to function as a mind, but in a limited form. For you will know that as you step out of the realm of lower mind into the realm of higher mind, that the texture and feeling of your thoughts will change. There will be peace and love, happiness, satisfaction, peace and contentment, while the higher mind assists you in your activities throughout the day by guiding you when you ask for it as a conscious creative being. But your lower mind will create all sorts of energies and emotions, conflicting emotions, intense emotions, all sorts of feelings, feelings of agitation, feelings of excitement, feelings of lethargy and dullness in your physical vehicle as it motivates you, as it creates for you, creates with you, or possibly creating against you in this very moment. For the mind is the same, but the mind operates at many levels of experience as your consciousness enters into more of your unconscious reality, changing it, bringing it into more fullness of who you really are as your true self here and now in this very experience. So we ask you, do you have the ability? Will you make the task of seeking to discern from where these desires are coming by becoming aware of their texture, their feeling, what they are stirring in you, what energies are arising before the thoughts of manifestation occur in your mind? For this is a teacher. Your energies are your teachers. Yes, the energy of fear. Yes, the energy of anger that you may resist so much, that you may label as bad or wrong, is a very high teacher for you. For when you change your views of perception, when you change the way you see the world, your experience of these emotions themselves will change. For you will realize the source of the rage, the source of the fear, as none other as yourself. And you will see this rage and the fear more completely, more holistically, as a teacher guiding you to uncover deeper and fuller parts of your being, to uncover more love and more light in your very heart, in your very experience. For know that you are the source of all that is created within your body, within your vehicle. Yet you are consciously co-creating with that source that is you, for your egoic mind may seek to take control, thinking that it can control all of reality in this very moment. But the truth is, your egoic mind cannot. Your egoic mind has given rein over a very small band of frequency, over a very small range of experience in your life, for your benefit, so that you can learn more about your conscious creative ability and so that you can transcend the limitations of ego identification and experience more of your divine self, where you are then given more experiences, more abilities, as you have now been released, freed from the bonds of karmic enslavement, of selfish identity, and moved into a fuller experience of yourself as awareness, peace, love, and light of a divine energy field, a divine being existing here and now in your very life. So you must discern. You must make the conscious effort to decide and understand from where your desires come from, knowing all the while that when you create from a place of limitation, that desires themselves will not leave you feeling fulfilled, for that is the very nature of this creation. But when instead, when you choose first to seek and feel and touch yourself more fully as God incarnate, as light and as love, as a source of pure conscious awareness, for as you connect with that, all of your manifestation desires will be fueled by that energy and will come to pass with effortlessness, with ease, for that is the experience from which you are creating your experience. So we encourage you to touch the part of yourself that can create effortlessly, that can create with clarity, that can create with ease, and all the while remain at peace. Peace if the event comes to pass, peace if it doesn't come to pass, all the while trusting in the source of you, the source of your inspirations, by knowing it more fully, by delving deeper within yourself.